Hey, today I want us to remember the points that I made this last week, just simply to recognize that within marriage, no doubt that you're going to have an ebb and flow. You're going to have a higher sexual frequency and a lower sexual frequency. You're going to have times where you're hit and you're missed. But the sooner you can work out a rhythm of consistency and priority because of the extra special nature of your sexual relationship, the more you're going to find passion doing five things that I talked about this week. The first one was simply that within marriage it's protected. That sacredness of marriage actually is going to protect the quality of your sexuality. Studies have shown that single people are not more sexually satisfied than married people. To the contrary, married people twice as much are more sexually satisfied than single people. That's because whenever we honor what God said about sexuality, we experience the fruit of that. You may be in a marriage where you're not experiencing that. So here's a couple other things that when they take place, it's going to increase your desire for a more passionate relationship. And that is whenever you have a greater priority to give love than to get love. If your spouse believes you have a greater priority to give love than get love, it's going to accentuate the physical experience. When your spouse believes that they are a higher priority than you are, your experience will be heightened and your satisfaction and your passion will be on the rise. Does your spouse feel like they're a higher priority than you? I have to regularly stop and think about the things that I think are a priority to me and then put that in comparison, juxtaposition to whether or not Debbie thinks that she's a higher priority than other things that I want to do. When I bring her to the place of being a higher priority, I check in with her, I listen to her, I spend the first part of my day with her. When those things are happening, she starts to believe she's a priority, and she is. She always is, but until my behavior matches that, it will tarnish our union. So when you make that sense of making your spouse, your bride, your groom, believe they're a higher priority than you, it will benefit your relationship. When you know what your spouse is hungry for, if you've not done the love languages, if you haven't checked out and what's my husband's love language, what are they hungry for in love in general and then in the physical relationship? What is pleasing to them? When that's your focus instead of just your own gratification, your passion in marriage is going to go up. And lastly, when your spouse feels cared for and forgiven, which within sexuality, it is one of the most powerful ways for a spouse to feel cared for and forgiven. If you are on the single side of sexuality, then I would encourage you, you've got something to look forward to, because the tenderness of care and forgiveness, because the priority of giving love instead of getting love, because of the sacredness of the marriage covenant, those things are going to actually accentuate your sexuality, not diminish your sexuality. So today, whatever side of the equation you're on the single side or the married side, let the true nature and heart of God flow into who you are as a sexual being and honor God with your sexuality. Lord Jesus, we dedicate afresh today who we are mentally, emotionally, relationally, physically, spiritually, and sexually back to you. Lord, when you call us to offer our bodies as living sacrifices, you're calling us to offer you all that we are, including our sexuality. We give it to you today. Lord, purify it, renew passion, bring protection, help our minds be focused on the things above that make our sexuality sacred, a sacred gift from you. We ask this in Christ's name. Amen. I'll see you tomorrow.